Welcome back. He's a new age entrepreneur who's done remarkably well in the last 7 years. But in 2001, he was almost wiped out. I caught up with Sandeep Engineer at his well-appointed office in Ahmedabad to find out what gave him the confidence and guts to doing business even though he was at ground zero. And this is what he has to say. Take a look. Sandeep Engineer, Sandeep Pal, welcome to the show. Okay, Sandeep, I may begin with you. It's quite unusual for somebody like you whose mother is an academic. She was a professor of Sanskrit. Your father dabbled in politics. Yet, you did not go either way, but chose to enter business. What is the reason behind entering business? Is it aspiration, inspiration, or simply a Gujarati trait?
One is Gujarati, and secondly, I was studying in the engineering college, and what I was seeing around is that there were opportunities of I choose chemical engineering for my subject and for my academic purpose, and I saw that there is a good opportunity to do something of your own in this line of chemical engineering. As soon as I passed out, or say before I passed out, my dreams were to do a small unit to run something of my own. So it was right from my college days, the inspiration of doing something of my own was there within me. When I passed out, we didn't have the capacity to put a unit or start a business, or we didn't have a background from my parents or the family to have how a factory should be put up and start running. So I joined Cadila as a project engineer to get more knowledge on how the projects are done, how you can build a project, what are the decision-making factors of a project. Working for some time, I left my job and then started the journey of entrepreneurship.
So you started trading in ISAB Gold, and from there you moved into making API for bulk intermediates.
I started with ISAB Gold. This was the company who first time marketed this product in different flavors and nice packing and all. It was a new thing for me, so I started from a scratch, got everything, how, where are the medical shops, which area has which shop, and started from a small garage, which was my office, and one more boy who was a delivery boy. Okay. And I myself used to go from shop to shop to sell the product. I went on a motorcycle.
Karsan Bipetal went in a cycle to
yeah.
build
Nirma. I had a motorcycle, luckily. So I went on shop to shop, and then it was a new product. So sometimes if the guy is free, he will call you. If he's not free, he will not even dare to talk to you. So all these things I learned at the childhood, that of my entrepreneurship childhood, what you can say.
And what happened then? You switched on to making set up a small pharma unit. How did that happen?
When this product clicked, this unit, and the government and the owner had issues, though they shut the unit. So I came to ground zero. So I started trading in API. I used to go to Vapi, Baroda, and get people who were making API to get their product, get it introduced to the pharmaceutical companies, get orders. But as the capital was a constraint, they used to directly go after getting the first order through me.
Okay.
So that inspired me that this is not the way to do it. So then I said, let me make something of my own. And that brought me to making API. So I went into active pharma ingredients. And not to forget that at that time, Cadila and Pankaj Patel himself is a mentor for me, helped me to put the unit, to give me a product. He said, whatever you make, we'll buy it. Okay. So that was the inspiration.
What made you get into a relatively new business like polymer?
CPVC is a product which was invented by B.F. Goodrich. And my uncle was the R&D chief of B.F. Goodrich.
Helped you?
It didn't help me. I'd seen CPVC. He used to come to India when I was in my chemical engineering days and just passed out, and go around to meet all the big players of plastic piping in India and tell them that this is the product, you must look at it and you must come into CPVC. Everyone laughed away that no, CPVC won't never be India, you will never accept it, India will never change. So he used to come very often, so he had shown me, and I thought that at some point of time this is a product which it's a new challenge and something which we can take up.
How did you manage to convince the architect, the plumber, who was so used to GI pipe, to switch to polymer, which was 30% costlier than GI pipe? What did you do to make the switch happen?
Let me just go a little behind that. First was my challenge of industrial piping.
Okay.
So I could not convince the industry to change from metal to plastic.
Okay.
Means polymer or CPVC. I just give you a case. There was a big metal unit near Ahmedabad only. They had problems every 6 months. They use sulfuric acid concentrated and line used to fail. When we went with CPVC, they said, we don't trust. So you install this much line, we don't pay you if it runs 1 year, because our line fails in 6 months. If this runs 1 year, then you come back to us. And we took these challenges. And after 1 year and till today, this line is running. But industry-wise, we didn't even break even.
Okay.
We started accumulating losses. And in 2 years of operation of Corzen or the industrial CPVC, we accumulated such a loss that our working capital was all eaten away. In 2000 and 2001, we were almost on the bankruptcy.
But at that time, your banker also went belly up?
But as we went, we thought, discussing with Thompson's, we said, let's come into plumbing and let's try out plumbing business. Even plumbing did not take up. What your question is, that plumbing also did not take up because it was costly, 30% costly. I used to import fittings from US because I was only making pipes. So I used to go to the market myself. One day I came back that what is hurting us the biggest thing? What is our biggest challenge? That everyone says, pulls out the GI price list, Tata B class or something, Jindal or XYZ brand, and then says that you are not matching, you are costly. So I just came and I said, let's change our price list. Let's put exactly the price which GI is selling. Then they have no question, I think. So we did that. We did that correction. We had to take some hit in some of the sizes. We were not even covering the raw material cost. And I said, this is the last avenue for Astral to survive or get accepted. We went with this new price list and the things started changing. There were two game changers. One was this correction, and second, we went again to Thompson's. We all sat for 3 days and we all plowed back capital. And we knew that all the margins in plastic comes from fittings. So we said, we have to make fittings here.
One direct question. You had so many setbacks. At any point in time, did you feel that what have I done? I should go back 9-to-5 job. Did you feel that way?
Job never came to me because I did feel that whether a plastic I am in the right thing. That really came to my mind at some point of time. But I said, now I don't have any choice, because if I make that unit die, even my pharma unit will have problems, because I put some capital, not some, but almost a crore of capital from a pharma to this unit. And at that time, close to crore is a huge, huge amount. Yeah. So I had to survive. I had to take up the challenge.
Is it a do or die for you?
It was a do and die for me.
Okay, let me get Sandeep Uppal in. 2007 and 2013, look, both the top line and the bottom of this company has been 40% plus. So it's a banker's delight to have such company as your client. And for a company like this, which has got a good credit rating also, does it mean they get a good, at a fine rate, the money for this people?
Obviously, the growth over that period has been phenomenal. And from a banker's perspective, it's always good to work with customers who are obviously growing. As you always say, we cannot grow faster than our customers. So we are dependent on them for our growth. It's really good to see a company which is growing rapidly. But I think the important part is rapid growth has to be backed up by very sound financial management. So you're not really only focused on the top line growth, because over the same period, and if you go back and look at the Indian industry, we'll come across a lot of people who had similar rates of growth, but they didn't look at the bottom line. Yeah. So you had growth, but you're sitting in 2013 and wondering what do you do with the business, because you have to restructure it. I think what we like about Astral is that they kept the growth, but they kept the margins also very rock solid. They kept the capital structure of the company rock solid. So what they were really looking for a business is a sustainable longer term business. They're not there to set the record of turnover that I want to be a 1,000 crore company, I want to be a 5,000 crore company. Again, going back to what I said, they had a model which works for them. It is tried and tested. Execution is on a sustainable basis, and that's what we like about that.
What are the message you're giving your two sons who will eventually take over your business one day? What are the do's and don'ts they should do?
One is that they should be on the ground. Reality always comes on the ground. Ground is two things. They have not to get into that we are now a conglomerate or just a big company and so we can ride on it. And second is ground, I say, is always go to the market is the ground. I always make it a point, any market I go to the core of the market. I sit with a distributor on his cable in his shop, have his tea, coffee, whatever. That's where the drama is unfolding. So one thing, they have to be on this thing. Second is accuracy. You have to be perfect. Whatever you do in your business, if you want to grow, you have to be very, very perfect. You have to have your perfection with time, work, everything. Because from top, the perfection goes to the bottom.
Okay. That was a wonderful insight. Thanks a lot, Sandeep Engineer, and Sandeep for being on the show. It was a pleasure having you here.
Thank you.
That's Sandeep Engineer playing straight bat and telling us how he surmounted three setbacks in business. These are the mantras Sandeep implemented to build Astral Polytechnic. Integrity is a must to succeed in business. Do not try to do too many things. Be focused on one area and make it a success. Never give up. You have to be a fighter to succeed. Never get into business where technology changes by the day. Have feet firmly on the ground and be in touch with your trade from the grassroots level. Interesting mantras, and it has certainly paid Sandeep Engineer rich dividends. In fact, Sandeep has been earnestly asking his two sons to follow these mantras in letter and spirit. As they say, if you have your head on your shoulder, then nothing can go wrong. On that thinking note, it is time to say goodbye. See you next week with another interesting episode. Till then, keep watching CNBC TV 18.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.